Discord experiences a lot of crime, and as a result, there are loads of police investigations related to Discord. Today, we're going to be talking about that. But first, make sure to go and hit the subscribe button and that like button. If this video gets 4,000 likes, I will do a cooking stream. And anyways, let's get straight into the story. So on the 5th of April, there was a particular police report that was published by a place in Connecticut. I believe the place is called South Windsor. And it was talking about the application Discord and the fact that there has been a massive increase in police investigations over recent months related to the platform. So what did they actually say in this police report? Well, effectively, in this police report, they noted that obviously investigations are rising. So there's been more investigations about Discord than ever, well, especially in that state alone, and that it is a lot to do with adults that are pretending to be children talking to children. You may be wondering, for the naive people that are watching this, why would adults, you know, pretend to be children to talk to children? Unfortunately, that is, that's to do with basically child exploitation and stuff like that. It's not very good stuff, and unfortunately, there are some people that are completely sick-minded in this world that are just absolutely, we have no words for them, honestly. They just need to be put behind bars, honestly, and locked away for the key to be thrown as well, because we don't want these people out. And unfortunately, Discord is going to have their fairest share of people, you know, like that on the platform. You're not going to be able to do checks like this before someone gets onto Discord, so there will be, you know, the bad apples within the community. And the bad apples in the community do try and take advantage of some children on the platform. Obviously, you know, Discord's supposed to be 13 plus, and a 13-year-old is still way below, you know, any legal age for a lot of the stuff that you could probably think of. Yeah, it's not great, and Discord's had a bit of a problem with it over the time. So, as you can see, I mean, through Discord's transparency reports, they've had a fair share of users get banned for exploitive content. You just look at the figures on screen right now, for example. Those are 2020, start of 2020 and end of 2020. There was a notable decrease, slight decrease between the start of 2020 and the end of 2020 related to exploitive content, but not by much. But this was published in April, so there could be a new increase that we might see in the next transparency report. We don't know. But effectively, they did put out a few, you know, words alongside this. They said that obviously, they want parents to make sure that their kids are safe, so they want privacy settings being put on their Discord accounts, make sure that they have secure passwords and good, strong two-factor authentication. They want to make sure that their friend requests are off and their DMs are off as well, especially for the younger teenagers on the platform. Remember, you do have to be 13 plus to use Discord, so you can't really use it under that, but there will be some kids that still do, and it is a bit of a mess, but unfortunately that is how it happens, and there are just more people that seem to be trying to exploit kids at the moment, because we're in the middle of a pandemic, more people are at home, so I guess more people are using Discord as a means to do that. So for the server owners out there at Discord, and also to the users, you may have younger brothers and sisters, please make sure you keep an eye on your user base, or your brothers and sisters, or your friends. Make sure they're safe, make sure that they don't get fallen into any traps, and if they do seem like they're going to be meeting up with somebody, please make sure that they are safe, because I don't want anything going on, and obviously this isn't a good time for a lot of people. Discord did say that they want to make sure that kids are safe, and it is one of their top priorities, so if any parents do have any concerns for child safety, make sure to contact them using their form. I will put that in the description of today's video for any parents that might be watching this. I mean, probably not. My audience is mainly teenagers, so you never know. I would just put that in the description just in case. But overall, yeah, I wanted to make this video more as a public safety message and also to talk about my experience of it. I mean, I've been a server owner and I've obviously experienced some pretty sick people before that honestly just need to be put behind bars, as I said. So you really got to keep an eye out if you are a server owner. Make sure you keep an eye out for child safety and stuff like that, and make sure anything goes to Discord if you do find anything, please, because it's not great. But yeah, there is an uprising in investigations. Obviously, there are other investigations related to Discord, like extremist groups and stuff like that. So if you do stumble across anything like this, guys, just make sure to report it to Discord. We don't want this stuff on the platform, so go and do that. Anyways, that is all from me for today's video. I wanted to make this, you know, an interesting informational video more like, so it isn't really giving my opinion on it. It's basically just telling you the facts of what's going on. So just hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, and I will see you on Friday for the next video. Have an awesome day and peace out. My brain like a hurricane, destroying everything in your way. Spend my